spiced shrimp. Much for joining for tasting time. Hi, I'm Katie O'Reilly, and welcome to KDO's Food Carnival. Spice it up global style. What are we doing here? We're not talking heat. We are talking flavor. Flavor from the world. Things that maybe you have never even heard of or have no idea what they're about. I am going to give you an intro course into deciding how to work with these, when to work with these, and if they fit into your palate. Used to be that we only cooked with what was around us. And nowadays, it's just the click of a mouse and you can have any spice you want. I'm going to teach you the difference between herbs and spices, but let's get going in the carnival kitchen and do some cooking. Spicing it up global style. We are starting it off with nigella seeds. The inspiration behind this episode, this series of episodes, is really because there's so many spices out there that we might hear of and have no idea about. We might see them in an episode, but we never really hear the chefs talk about how you would use them or where they came from. Nigella seeds are originally from the India, North Africa area, and it is a seed which is also called black seed. And it's got a nuttier, toastier, more bitter flavor than oregano. We are gonna have some fun. Let's dive in. So, for Indian-inspired dishes, because they go great in curries, I am going to show you a buttery nigella rice with a paneer. So, I've got my sauteed onions and green peppers. See how they're kind of browning up? This is what I'm going to add to this. This is a little chicken stock, about 3/4 cup. I've got 2 teaspoons of the nigella seeds. I love them in there. Yay. Little chili pepper to seasoning. You add what you like. And I've got tomato paste going in. And my spices include, my fresh spices are garlic and ginger, about 2 teaspoons of each. Get that right in there. This can all be mixed together beautifully. And then I'm going to add my combination curry powder. This is dried, and it is raw because it's going into the mixture and it'll cook right in there. So that's fabulous. Oh, that smell is really coming up. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna mix that all together, stew in our tomatoes, 1 cup of canned stewed tomatoes, diced tomatoes, get that all covered, and then the paneer that we just browned is going right in there. Cover it all up, make sure everything is nice and mixed. Then we are going to turn down our heat. Look at that, that is going to be beautiful. Put a cover on it, put a lid on it, baby. Turn down our heat, let it simmer, and wait till you see what comes out. Nigella basmati rice. This is a quick and easy thing. A little bit of olive oil in your pan. And what they call, in most cultures, a knob of butter. So you use your own discretion. So let's get that butter, a little knob in there. What we wanna do is melt that down, okay? My pan's a little hot, but that's okay because we wanna melt it fast. And what we're gonna do is we are going to add, once this is nice and melted, which it almost is, we are gonna add our nigella seeds. And I'm gonna add 2 teaspoons. Okay, and these are going in, and this is my basmati rice, about 1 cup. What I want to do with this is just nicely coat it. Make sure it's nice and coated. Once it's nicely coated, we're going to add our cup of cold water. That's going to quickly come to a boil, and what we're going to do is cover that up. Now reduce your heat and let it go for 15 to 20 minutes. And take it off the heat, and you've got perfect rice. Don't lift that lid. The Jaffa paneer is so tomato-y, and it goes with that nigella rice beautifully. Mmm. These lamb chops, I'm going to call them lamb ribs, are delicious. Check out this. I have in front of me olive oil. Even though there's a lot of fat on the lamb, we need a little olive oil to get this marinade kind of sticking on it. Four cloves. This is the four recipe. 4 teaspoons of olive oil, 4 cloves of garlic, right in there. 4 teaspoons of soy sauce. Yum. A little salt in there. Then I've got 4 teaspoons of our cumin seeds. And then I've got 4 teaspoons, which is our specialty recipe item, nigella seeds. These are so cool. We want to get those in there. They're nice and petite. Okay, stir that all up so you have a great mixture, nice and wet. We want to get sloppy with this one. Let's get our ribs all sloppy. Look at those beautiful lamb ribs. And we are gonna douse those. Get them all covered beautifully, almost to like a soupy level, because they are gonna slow cook. And as I always love to do, I'm gonna do one more of these for you. Yeah, that's a great mixture. It's gonna stick right on there with that little extra olive oil. And I'm gonna show you our kitchen magic when we pull it out of our 350 degree oven for 2.5 to 3 hours, believe it or not. They're gonna be dripping gooey. We're gonna set them on here. The seasoning and spices are gonna get crispy but not burnt, and these are gonna be fascinating to eat. Wait until they hit your tongue. And when you are diving into these, you want napkins. Tender, juicy, flavorful, and of course, what else? Meaty. And lamb is so gamey, but mixed with those spices, you can taste that nigella seed right on there. With all those other spices, it's fabulous. Another great idea is when you have a garden full of squash, what do? You make a squash soup with nigella seeds and parsley. This is incredible. Mix it with a little potato and onion when you're making it. It looks green even though it was yellow squash. It's incredible. Those nigella seeds get nice and dark. And they brighten the flavor of that squash and make it craveable. Okay, one thing that nigella also does is it has a lot of like flexibility. It can go into pastries. So I'm showing a Turkish pastry here, which is so unique. And you just, it's a Christmas specialty in Turkey. You stuff it with your favorite cheese, either a blue cheese or a feta cheese, and then you glaze it and you top it with those nigella seeds. So it adds that element of the spice right on your tongue as you're eating it. It's delicious. And it really kind of makes it an experience that represents the spice world. What's the difference between herbs and spices? Let's stop there for a minute. Herbs we are so familiar with are things with leaves. They're usually the leaf or the flower that we can cook with. Spices are the seeds or the nuts or the pits, and they're usually dried, and it's phenomenal. So that's our difference there. Perfect example. Cilantro is the leaf, coriander is the seed that we would grind down. Just a real cool fact to know so you're not confused when we're working with this. I also have what is really interesting. I'm not going to show a lot of desserts because these spices don't lend themselves, but nigella does, and it goes in a berry crumble, and it goes into the crumbly mixture, and it really marries beautifully with those berries, adding almost like a flowery note of that seed into the crumble, which enhances the berry flavor. Delicious! I'm so excited. Let's keep moving. Hi, Katie-O, and welcome back to the Carnival Kitchen. Moving right along, the nigella seeds were so exciting, and oftentimes a spice that's kind of confused with them is called kala jeera. It is black cumin, and it has nothing to do with the same plant. However, oftentimes people confuse the two. Totally different flavor, totally different spice. It's part of the parsley family. Has different properties of healing
and dishes that it would be present in. So here we are, I'm gonna do some hardcore Indian cooking with you and create an amazing curry, Alu Gobi Mutur. What is that? Cauliflower, peas, potatoes. Let's get cooking with a curry. We've got basically three large sized diced tomatoes. Include the water in there. I've got two nice sized diced onions. I've got a little red chili powder. I've got that's a teaspoon. And I've got a full tablespoon of garlic and ginger paste and some coriander leaves that have been dried and ground up. Love that. And if you're ever so daring, three or four strips of your green chili. Let's get mixing. Hideo bringing you over to the stove to continue making that Alu Gobi Mutur. Olive oil in the pan. We are on a medium heat and we're gonna add, which is our featured spice, our Kala Jeera. Look at that. Along with hing, which is a vegetarian Indian spice, which is a fabulous powder mixture for all Indian spicing of dishes. You can smell it. I wish you were here to smell it with me. We're gonna just toast that up a little bit, get that going. About a half a minute on that, medium heat. And we're gonna add some more chopped onions. Once that's getting nice and softened and toasty, we're gonna add that mixture we just made. And let's reduce that in there for 7 to 8 minutes. Stir that all in. After about 2 minutes of stirring this and reducing this on your medium heat, we're gonna add our garam masala, some turmeric along with some beautiful cumin powder and some salt and pepper. Look at that. Now we're gonna go about 7 to 8 minutes cooking this. This has been cooking for about 7 to 8 minutes. Now we're ready to add our raw cauliflower florets. Add our potatoes, which have been soaking for about 10 to 15 minutes. They're cubed and soaking in salt water, but not cooked, so they are raw. Let's get those in there. Get those all covered. And we add our peas. And I like to add a little bay leaf. Get that all completely covered in there. And we are going to cover and bring it down and let it simmer. Wait until you see what comes back. So easy. And this is so beautiful when you mix it with your rice. If you're a vegetarian, oh my God, you are missing nothing. It's well-rounded, earthy flavors that have that beautiful developed curry flavor that are incredible and so easy to make if you follow my steps. I know it seemed a little aggressive, but it's not. It's easier than you think. And I'm about to tackle with you a lamb curry, which is basically what you want to see how to make. This is so cool. Little olive oil in your pan. My lamb has been marinating for over 24 hours in a garlic and ginger paste. That's it, just rub it on those pieces. Let's get those in the hot pan. And what we're gonna do is heat those, browning them up for about 7 to 8 minutes. Oh, the sizzle, let's get those spices in there too. Now that you see that these have gotten nice and brown, we're gonna add our diced tomato. Oh, look at all that water can add moisture. And let's cover that and cook for another 8 minutes. We're gonna add our chopped onions. Now that those tomatoes have broken down, and our chili powder. Now, we're gonna get that all lacquered up. We're gonna cover and reduce for about a half hour. About halfway through the cooking process, about 15 minutes in, start mixing a cup of yogurt, just plain yogurt, with a tablespoon of coriander leaves ground up,
some of our kalajira seeds, our cumin, and our turmeric, and some black pepper. Stir that all in. Each of those spices are a tablespoon or so, depending on your spice level and your flavor profiles. Get that all mixed in and watch this technique. We're gonna lift our lid. We're gonna take it off our heat a little bit, and we're gonna slowly start mixing this in. Once the entire mixture is mixed in, we're gonna cover and simmer for another 50 minutes. Oh, wait until you see the results. This is such an incredible dish, and what we really love to do is serve that with a raita, so it cools it down, and a little bit of pita bread, and we are in for action, and this is just falling apart. We stewed it so well. Cheers to you and I and our cooking abilities. Mmm, oh my God, that flavor is so infused with that lamb. Lamb can be so beautifully gamey, and that is amazing, like gamey in a good way, with all those spices mixed in it. And I just garnished it with some fresh ginger, coriander or cilantro leaves, and mint. Just amazing. A Bengali lentil risotto is amazing. And we take that kalajira at the very end, we mix it in with our risotto in the mixture. However, at the very end, we toast it up for about 45 seconds with some ghee, which is some Indian butter, which is reduced. You have to look it up, it's amazing. So they just kind of stir it in at the last minute for that extra creaminess. So lentils are such a part of the Indian diet that I wanted to show something so cool as an Indian risotto. Neat. Chicken biryani, if anybody's ever traveled through India, most favorite dish of all is usually a chicken biryani. It cooks in one pot. It's so many levels and so many spices that go into it, but when it's all done, you just flip it over and serve it. It's amazing. There's not a lot to say except that a limeade in India topped with a little black sea salt and a little kalajira is a refreshing drink. It's dynamite. And then I put a little kalajira right on these tea biscuits. And if you love your chai tea, that's a perfect marriage. These are savory with a little bit of spicy. Mmm. A perfect tea time treat. We'll be right back. Hi, Katie O. Welcome back to the Carnival Kitchen. Our next spice is ajwain. So intriguing. This one is black caraway. Wonderful ingredient. When toasted up, it has the flavor of thyme. Comes from the dill family. It's fabulous. You're gonna be introduced to this and you are gonna love it. And it adheres its flavor and wraps it into those ingredients. So you are going to definitely dive into these dishes like nothing else. Check it out. In India, they have this dish right here, which is a breakfast item. Saduk, I might get the pronunciation incorrect. Sadi koki. And it's served with raita and chutney and pickles in the morning, Indian style pickles. Some of your favorite bitter tart treats. If you're into savory breakfast, this is amazing. It's fried up in your ghee and served warm. Ugh, it's incredible. Flavors of coriander, little green pepper, green onion, all mixed in there into this fabulous wrapper. It carries these ingredients. Moving right on, I'm gonna take you into a region that is kind of more Asian, bordering, you know, the atmosphere is the atmosphere, the environment is the environment, and ingredients grow where they may. So this is kind of a crossover between some Asian influence and some Indian influence, and this is spicy chili shrimp. Let's check it out. This is gonna be featuring our ajwain, which is our beautiful black caraway. We are gonna start with a little olive oil. So what we wanna do is toast up in the oil our dry spices. I've got our ajwain, 1 tablespoon. Check that out. That is so beautiful. It's got a nutty aroma, and when it's cooked, it almost takes on the flavor of a really robust thyme. This is just red chili, dried and ground up, about 2 tablespoons, you decide. And this is coriander. So we're gonna put that in as well. And as we heat up, we are gonna coat our dry spices about 30 seconds, 45 seconds, just to get them nice and toasted before we add our following ingredients, which are going to be the base. We're gonna saute up our onions. Ooh, hear that sizzle? I love that sound. Right, get those nice and caramelized. We're on a medium heat right now. After those are nice and caramelized, I'm gonna speed up the process. We're gonna add 2 large diced tomatoes. Get those in there. That water is going to infuse in. Get that nice and heated, but this doesn't have to cook too much before you add the rest of your ingredients. You just wanna get this nice and sorted through, mixed in. And because we don't want to bruise the other ingredients, we have 2 cloves of garlic all chopped up. We have, of course, our beautiful pureed ginger. I love ginger and garlic. Onion, tomato seem to be a theme here. I'm liking it. And then what we want to do is we want to get this all stirred in again. And we are going to then mix in our shrimp at the last minute, along with our coriander and a little lemon juice.
Wait until you see this dish pulled together. When it's done, I love to put the shrimp in with their tails on, because when you cook them with a little bit of their shell, they have a tendency to infuse the sauce with a little bit more seafood flavor. Mmm. Those seeds and nuts that we mixed in are highlighted all over that recipe, and that sauce just encompasses them and invites you to take another bite. It's intriguing to your palate and building the whole time you're eating it. Not a lot of spice from the chilies, which is good. For those of you who do not love a lot of heat, you can always add it if you want to. That's the secret on that one. I've got a soup. Carrot soup with ajwain is a balanced soup like none other. Sometimes carrot soup can get a little one-dimensional, but when you add that ajwain, it adds a full-bodied aroma and a taste quality. And as I mentioned, when it's toasted up, it takes on the properties and the elements of kind of thyme, like a rustic thyme, robust. Top that with a little black pepper and lemon, and you are so good to go. Let's show you something easy. I've shown you some complicated recipes. Mushroom tikka. Check it out. Literally clean your mushrooms. Wash them, dry them, take off the stems. Stick them in your bowl, and we're gonna start adding our ingredients. More marinade is gonna be going on here because I just wanna demo a little bit, but that is olive oil, tablespoon, 2 tablespoons, I'm sorry. 1/4 tablespoon of ginger, and the same with garlic. We love our ginger and garlic in these recipes. Set these aside. And then we are gonna go with a new ingredient, which is called besom, which is a flour. And that's going to, oh, that's amazing. That's gonna bind everything together. We've got our ajwain seeds. Let's dump those in, 1/4 tablespoon. We've got garam masala, an Indian spice mixture, which adds so much depth to the tikka that you're gonna just need it and want it, but you can buy that at any Indian store or spice store. Little bit of turmeric, that's about 1/8 tablespoon. And then, of course, we've got our chili powder, which is like a red roasted chili. And all we have to do is stir this all up, make it into a marinade, get it all coated on the mushrooms. Once these are nice and coated, you're gonna see what we're gonna do is skewer them. We're gonna let it sit for about 25 minutes just to marinate. So let it sit, put it on your skewers. If you want to soak your skewers in advance, you can, but you're not going on the grill, so not as important on this one. You're going in the oven. And our kitchen magic is going to show us, voila! And this is on a 375 degree oven for 20 to 25 minutes until they're nice and coated and rustic. You're going to love this dish. Super spicy. And these have a huge element of spice going on, so I love to serve them with some fresh naan bread,
and that is flavor heaven. It is really bursting in my mouth, but it's got some heat going on with that chili. And that mixture of ingredients, you could use a chutney with that or a raita again to cool it down. Whatever your level is, you go there. But that's an amazing ingredient and a vehicle to carry those spices. I have a chicken dish that is just covered in seeds and nuts and stewed down so beautifully. I'm gonna have all of these recipes and all of the menus in their full name on my website so you can see all of it. This has the ajwain seeds mixed in. It has about 50 ingredients in there. And the flavors are so layered. It may not invite you and entice you immediately with your eyes, but your palate will not stop wanting to go back. It builds with flavor, dimensional flavor, and not a lot of heat, so you're not burning out those taste buds. It is just a real treat. Ajwain is an incredible ingredient that is fantastic to add into any of these dishes. Please go try it. And the health benefits, as with all of them, building our immune systems, doing all of it, it's there. The properties are there. Try it out. Be right back. Hi, Katie O. Welcome back to the Carnival Kitchen. I am going to combine our last two spices because these are both kind of souring agents for different ingredients and chutneys and things. Both of them come from fruit that we are all familiar with. The names themselves, totally unfamiliar. What they are, let me explain to you. Amchur. Amchur is when you take an unripened mango and you dry it out and grind it into a powder. So it actually becomes this zesty, flavorful, almost citrusy when added to ingredients. Like I said, a chutney or something like that, and I'm gonna show you some other things. The other one is an aradana. And aradana is pomegranate seeds that have been dried and ground into a powder as well. So both fruit powders, so cool, can be added as agents to anything. If you're trying to make your marinade for your meats, add them in there. I've got here a trout with the amchur. And the beautiful thing is that I've marinated the trout before I grilled it and made a zesty mango salad with it, with that cilantro, peanut, and coconut. It becomes a lively, decadent meal in your mouth, and you definitely are gonna eat with your eyes first. That fish is beautiful, and the mango salad both have that spice. Mango salad with the green mango powder is a marriage made in heaven because it's that ripe and that unripe. So zesty. I'm gonna move right along. I've made an aradana chutney with the pomegranate seeds ground down. And that chutney is paired with a pakora, cauliflower pakora. Okra with the mango powder is incredible. It's beautiful and bright and stews in there beautifully. Such a marriage. I love this as a vegetarian dish. The chana masala is mixing many of the ingredients we've already seen in our Indian cuisines. However, we're also mixing in the amchur for that little level of sourness. And when you mix it in with your chickpeas and your tomatoes and your onions and your garlics and your ginger, all those beautiful ingredients, stew it down, the sweet potato meets that sour and becomes a bite that intrigues your palate and all of your senses. So everything, this rice is just literally an aradana rice mixed with cashews and so many nuts and various ingredients, chickpeas, beautiful color, beautiful ingredients, all kinds of chicken skewers with either of those spices. Like I said, they marinate chicken so beautifully. Have at it, mix it with onions and pita. There's so many recipes out there. Intriguingly enough, either of these spices, but in particular, the aradana, that pomegranate seed, just sprinkle it on fruit, grilled fruit, fresh fruit, anything. It's going to give it a lively touch. This has been such an amazing first of a three-part series of Global Spices. We are moving on, and I'll see you soon in the next episode of KDO's Food Carnival. You know it's my pleasure when you join me.
See you soon.